Shikishamanam,
Tam,
Sapataya. 他的继母苏瑞奇顿时怒火中烧， 竟然嫉妒起这个孩子来。他趾高气扬地开始发作，嗓音大得足以让君王也能听到。要旨。
The king, of course, was equally affectionate towards both his sons, Usama and Dhruva. So he had a natural inclination to take Dhruva as well as Uttama on his lap. But because of his favoritism towards his queen, Suruchi, he could not welcome Dhruva Maharaj despite his feelings.King Uttanapada's feeling was understood by Suruchi, and therefore, with great pride, she began to speak about the king's affection for her. That is the nature of woman. If a woman understands that her husband regards her as a favorite, she is especially affectionate.And is especially affectionate to her, she takes undue advantage. These symptoms are visible even in such an elevated society as the family of Swayambhuva Manu. Therefore, it is concluded that the feminine nature of woman is present everywhere.
要旨，君王对乌特玛和都尔这两名儿子肯定都同样疼爱，因此自然也愿意对待，也愿意像对待乌特玛那样，把朱尔玛哈拉吉抱在自己的膝盖上。但由于他特别宠幸的属入起王后，所以便只能违心的不对朱尔玛哈拉吉表示欢迎。属入起明白乌特玛帕达的感受，因此便自负起来，大讲君王如何对他宠而有加，这就是妇人的天性。假若妇人知道丈夫宠爱自己，偏爱自己，便会变本加厉。这些真后就算在斯瓦扬布瓦马努这样等高等的家族中也能见到。因此结论是，妇人特有的本性随处可见。
grew up he was the brother of Dhritarashtra.
维多拉是 Dhritarashtra 的兄弟。
And he was living in the palace with the sons of Dhritarashtra.
他和这个 Dhritarashtra 住在这个宫殿里。
But he got driven out of the palace.
但是他被这个逐出了这个宫殿。
Because the eldest son of Dhritarashtra.
因为这个 Dhritarashtra 的年长的儿子。
Did not like Vidura.
他特别不喜欢维多拉。
Because Vidura would tell Dhritarashtra, "Don't listen to your son."
他告诉 Dhritarashtra, 不要去听你儿子的话。
You tell Dhritarashtra, "That son of yours is no good. He's very evil, very bad person. Why don't take any advice from him? Don't listen to him."
你儿子是一个恶魔的品质，非常非常不道德，很多。不好的品质，你为什么要去听聆听他的话呢？
So then Duryodhana, the son of Dhritarashtra, heard this, and so he told Vidura, his uncle, "You get out from this."
所以他的儿子这个 Duryodhana 听到这一段对话之后，就把他的叔叔逐出了王宫。
So this was a blessing for Vidura.
但是这对维多拉来说是一个祝福。
Because he got out of the palace, which was very materialistic.
因为他离开了一个非常物质化的皇宫。
He was able to go and visit the holy places.
于此呢，他就可以去绕拜各种各样的圣地了。
And he met this Maitreya.
然后他就遇见了 Maitreya.
He met Maitreya at Hardwa.
他在 Hardwa 这个地方遇见了 Maitreya.
You've been to Hardwar?
你们去过 Hardwar 这个城市吗？
Hardwar is the gateway to the land of Hari. The gateway to Hari.
Hardwar 这个城市，它被誉为是是这个哈瑞这个城堡，主哈瑞的这个大门。
Hari means the supreme lord.
哈瑞是至尊人格首神。
So it's at the foot of the Himalayas.
它也是在喜马拉雅山的脚下，恒河也流经此地，是一个非常特别的地方。我们在那里有两个 ISKCON 的中心。Maitreya 也在那里有一个修院，然后 Vidura 在那里去见拜见了 Maitreya。他从 Maitreya 那里聆听了不同的 Manu。在 Brahma 的一天有十四个 Manu。他聆听了这个 Brahma 的第一天，也就是第一个 Manu， 聆听了关于 Swayambhuva Manu 的这个事。
Swayambhuva Manu， one of the sons of Swayambhuva Manu was Uttanapada。
其中第一个 Swayambhuva Manu 的这个被称为
Uttanapada。
Uttanapada。
There were two sons actually. One was Priyavrata。
他其实有两个儿子，第一个儿子叫 Priyavrata， 第二个儿子叫 Uttanapada。 他有三个女儿 Devahuti、Akuti、Achuti。 他们都是非常伟大的这个人物。
So Swayambhuva Manu was like the emperor. He had a big palace.
Swayambhuva Manu 呢是一个国王，他有一个巨大的宫殿。
So Uttanapada, he took over from Swayambhuva Manu.
Uttanapada 他接管了这个王位。
And Uttanapada had two wives, Suniti and Suruchi.
Uttanapada 呢有两个老婆，第一个叫 Suniti， 第二个叫 Suruchi。
Suniti and Suruchi both had sons.
Suniti 和 Suruchi 都有儿子。
The son of Suniti's son was called Dhruva.
Suniti 的儿子叫 Dhruva.
Dhruva means somebody who is very determined.
Dhruva 的意思是一个非常有决心的人。
And when we hear about the life of Dhruva Maharaj, when we hear how as a young boy he went to the forest, he was very determined.
如果我们了解朱瓦马哈拉吉的逍遥时光，他如何去到森林的话，你会发现他非常的有决心。
So, Suruchi's son was called Uttama.
Suruchi 的儿子叫 Uttama.
And they were both about the same age.
他们都是相同的年纪。
Both young children.
非常年轻的小孩。
But Maha Uttanapada.He had the two wives, but he liked one wife more than the other one.
Uttanapada 有两个老婆，他喜欢其中一个老婆多于另外一个。
He was more inclined to Suruchi rather than Suniti.
他对这个 Suruchi 更加的疼爱，相比于 Suniti 来说。
So describes here how the two boys came and they wanted to sit on the lap.
这里描述的两个小孩都想坐在父亲的腿上。
Now, father has two sons. Now he would like to have both his sons with him. Why only take one son?
父亲呢，其实都希望两个小孩都坐在他的腿上。
You feel twice the pleasure, right?
他能得到两倍的快乐，是吗
？Double happiness.
两倍的快乐。
But there was a problem.
但是呢，这里就有个问题了。
The problem was.This one wife, Suruchi, that she knew that her husband liked her more than Suniti.
这个时候的问题就是 ，Suruchi 她知道她的老公比更疼爱她。
So when Dhruva Maharaj tried to come up and sit on the lap of the father,
所以当朱瓦马哈拉吉他也爬上父亲正爬上父亲的腿时
，then.The queen said, Suruchi said, you cannot sit.
然后这个 Suruchi 就说你不能坐在你父亲的腿上。
Because you're not my child.
因为你不是我的儿子。
So you have no right.
因为你没有这个权利。
So Prabhupada explains, this is the nature of women, that they have that nature to take advantage of a man.
所以呢，这里就描述了这个妇女跟男的不一样的这个本性。
A woman, if a woman knows that the man is inclined, has a special affection for her, she will take advantage of him.
描述的这个本性就是，如果这个妇女知道男的对她更加疼爱，她就会特别不一样。
So, in the material world.
在物质世界，这样的情况经常发生。
Sometimes they say that if you have a wife who is very beautiful, it's a lot of trouble.
物质世界有这样的，如果你的妻子非常漂亮的话，你会招来很多的麻烦。
I knew this one man. He had his wife was known to be very beautiful.
我知道一个男士，他的妻子非常的美丽。
He refused to go out with his wife. He wouldn't go anywhere with her.
他不和他的妻子去任何的地方。
Because if wherever he went, people would say, "Oh, your wife is very beautiful."
因为他一出去的话，所有的男士都会说：“啊，你的妻子真美丽。
”So he got so fed up with it. He said, "I'm not going ever. I'm never going out with you ever."
所以他跟他跟他的妻子从来没有一起出去过。
So, here we see also the same thing. Although we're talking about very elevated people, like Uttanapada is a great king, and he's the son of Swayam Bhuva Manu, but he has a special affection for one woman more than the other. They're both his wife.
所以你看，我们这里描述了，即便非常伟大的人物， 家庭中的这个乌特曼哈达，他这么具有人格，而且接管的这个王室，他还是具有这样的情况会发生在他身上。当然，我们应该平等的对待每一个人。有些人会认为，如果我有两个妻子的话，我会更加的快乐。他会认为我有一个妻子很快乐，我如果有两个妻子就会更加的快乐。你可以在这个逍遥时光看到，有两个妻子恰恰相反，拥有更多的麻烦。
Somebody asked Prabhupada that Lord Rama was the supreme personality of Godhead, but he had been suffered so much in his life.
有人问圣帕帕德，主 Rama 是至尊人格首神，但是在他的逍遥时光中，你会发现他经历了那么多的困难。
Prabhupada said, "Yeah, this is to show you that wherever there's a woman, there will be problems."
帕帕就告诉他，哪里有女人，哪里就有麻烦。即便是至尊人格首身。
So here we see Maharaj Uttanapada is also going to get a problem.
我们在这个逍遥时光中看到乌特那帕达，他也得到了一些麻烦。
Because he cannot be equal with the two children.
因为由于这个妈的姐，所以她不可能平等的对待她的两个儿子。她被她美丽的妻子给控制住
了。
这个对于奉献者来说有什么启示？有人就问帕帕帕德，圣帕帕德，他说这是物质世界的这个人会这样，奉献者也会经历同样的问题吗？这里讲的是物质世界的女人。那么奉献者就应该处在超然的这个层面上，奉献者的妈的姐们。
We don't say women are unqualified or low born or of low birth.
我们奉献者不会去考虑妈的姐她的出身来自于一个很低的家族，不会考虑她的出身等等。
We see in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, "Mahi parta vai pashtya yepi shu papayonaya striyo vaishas tata sudras." But even we may be of, by birth low, we can attain the supreme destination if we're properly situated.
在这个圣国家梵歌中，有这么一个师姐，即便她出生在一个非常低等的家族，她也能够获得 Krishna 智觉。
So, in material life, people fall under the influence of these impressions.Being beautiful, somebody thinks I'm very beautiful, or somebody thinks my wife is very beautiful.
在物质世界，人们经常会为这些东西所束缚，都会想着我的妻子非常的漂亮。
So one has to come to the transcendental platform.
因此，人们应该达到一个超然的本性，超然的层面。
We have to understand the nature of the material body.
我们应该了解到物质躯体的这个物质本性。
Just like Prabhupada told his story about liquid beauty.
就像帕帕讲的一个故事，叫液体的美丽。
About the lusty man who saw the beautiful young woman.
讲的是一个非常色欲冲天的男的，想追求一个美女。
And he was the lusty man came to approach this beautiful young woman.And asked her to have some friend to make friends with him and have a relationship with him.
这个充满色欲的男的呢，想跟这个女子有一 种关系，想追求这个女子。
But the young woman said, "Oh, please don't talk to me like this. I'm already there's already arrangement for my marriage. I have another man already."
嗯，然后这个女子说，我已经有婚姻上的安排了，请你不要这么说话，也请你不要这么追求我。
But the man was very lusty. He said, "Oh, please, I'm so attracted by your beauty. I want to have a nice long relationship with you."
然后这个色充满色欲的男子就说，请你不要这样拒绝我，我被你的美丽深深的吸引。
So then the young woman was very intelligent. She told the man, she said, "We'll just come back after one week."
嗯，然后这个女子就说，非常有智慧，请你一个星期之后再来。
Just come back and see me after one week, and I will satisfy your desire.
嗯，等你一个星期来之后，我一定会满足你的。
So then the man agreed. He thought, "Oh, one week is not long. Okay, I'll come back after a week."
所以呢，那个男子就觉得一个星期并不是很长。既然你能满足我，那我就一个星期再来吧。
So then the man went away. Then the woman, she began to take medicine.
然后这个男子，这个男子走了之后，这个女子就开始吃一些药。
And this medicine would cause her to vomit.
然后这个女子呢，就开始吃各种各样的这种泻药，排泄她的这个物品，就是拉稀。
And all of her beauty, every day she was taking this medicine. Every day she was vomiting and passing loose stool. She became very, very thin.
每天她都吃这个泻药，把自己。拉的这个非常非常的瘦，然后非常非常的丑陋。
And all of her beauty disappeared.
所以呢，通过不断的排便，她的这个每天吃泻药，她的这个美丽逐渐的消失了。
And at the same time, all the things she was vomiting and passing, she kept them in buckets.
啊，她呕吐出来，她排泄出来的，她就用一个罐子装起来。
So after a week, the man came back and he was looking for the beautiful woman.
一个星期之后，这个男子就来找这个女子，他就来找这个美丽的女子。
And he said, "Where's that beautiful woman?"
他找了一圈没有找到这个美丽的女子，那个女子在哪？
And he could only see this very skinny and sickly-looking woman.
他只找到了这个又瘦又老又虚弱的女的。
Where's that beautiful woman, the one who was here?
那个美丽的女子在哪？他就问那个又瘦又虚弱的女的。
And she said, "Oh yeah, that was me."
啊，然后他就说，那个美丽的女子就是我。
You?
是你吗
？Where's your beauty? What happened to all your beauty?
你的美丽去哪里了
？Oh yeah, I kept it for you. It's all here.
我的美丽都在这个罐子里面。
So she showed all the buckets to the man.
他把这个罐子给了这个男的。
This is my beauty.
这就是我的美丽。
So the man was taught a lesson to understand the nature of the beauty of the material body.
这个故事就讲述了物质世界的美丽的一个事情。
So it appears from this pastime, Dhruva Maharaj's father, Uttanapada, he was not understanding this.
这里我们回到这个逍遥时光，乌塔那帕达，Maharaj 不知道。乌塔那帕达Maharaj 他不知道这样的情况。
So he's going to get a lesson.
然后他从这里他会得到一个故事，一个学习。
Yeah, he's under the control, because he's under the influence, he's in the bodily consciousness of life.
因为他躯体化的这个概念，他被控制了。
And he's not thinking about the actual nature of the material body.
他在思考这个物质化的生命概念。
to the one wife and lost all interest in the other wife.
他竟然喜欢其中一个妻子，然后失去了对另一个妻子的兴趣。
And so, in the Vedic culture, a man was allowed to have more than one wife, but the understanding was they must take care of all the wives.
在伟达文化中，一个男子可以娶多名妻子，但是呢，有一个条件。他必须很好地照看每一个妻子。我们在这里却能发现，要照顾一个妻子都非常困难。如果你有两个妻子，你会有两倍的麻烦。这不是意味着你得到两倍的快乐，而是两倍的麻烦。
Because there naturally one will become more affectionate to one, you develop more affection for one person over another. It's hard to be equal.
因为平等的对待两个人是非常困难的。
Also, when a man will take more than one wife, he has to get the permission from the first wife to accept the second wife.
同时呢，如果一个人要娶两个妻子，他必须得到第一位妻子的同意，他才能够娶第二个妻子。如果没有得到第一个妻子的同意，他不能娶第二个妻子。由于某种原因，这两个女的都成了乌塔拉帕达的妻子。
But he became controlled. He became too much affected.
但是呢，他对被其中的一个妻子的美丽特别严重的影响。
And when the wife saw the weakness in her husband, she took advantage of it.
当这个妻子她看到丈夫的弱点之后，她就利用这个弱点做出了一些事情。
So this is material nature.
这就是物质世界的本性。
That we see the weakness of someone and we take advantage for our own sense gratification.
如果我们发现一个人的弱点，我们就经常容易利用这个弱点去做一些事情，为了自己的感官享受。
When we see a weakness in someone, we should try to help them.
如果我们看到一个人的缺点，我们应该帮助这个人，而不是应该利用这个人的缺点来为了自己的方便。作为一个奉献者，人们应该，奉献者应该时常为了他人的福利而去工作。
So, this woman, Suruchi, she was wrong to take advantage of her husband.
这个苏如喜就是利用，她做的非常不对的，就是利用丈夫的缺点做了一些不好的事情。
So she needs to be taught also.
她也应该接受教育。
That how to deal properly, how to not to exploit the weakness, but to try to help the husband to get over that weakness.
如何不要去利用丈夫的缺点，而是弥补丈夫的缺点，帮助他。
And the husband, the king, Maharajutanapada, he has to also come out of this maya, this illusion.
Maharaj Uttanapada, 他也应该从这个虚幻能量中 maya 之中走出来。他应该走到超然的层面上。他应该成为一个灵性的导师 guru。因为一个丈夫是妻子的灵性导师。
They don't take care.Of the wife to help them on the spiritual path, then they're not doing the duty of the husband.
如果一个丈夫不把妻子提到灵性的层面，那么这个丈夫他没有 敬他的侄子。
And especially somebody who's a king, like Uttanapada.
尤其是对于像乌塔那帕达这样的国王来说。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, among men, I am the monarch.
在国家梵歌中说，在所有的人中，我是王者。
So Dhruva Maharaj's father, Uttanapada, he's a representative of Krishna.
所以从这个层面上来讲，乌塔那帕达也代表了 Krishna。
So he should not be controlled by the beauty of a woman.
他不应该被一个美女子的美丽所控制。
He should properly control his mind and senses.
他应该控制他的心意和感官。
So, of course, this takes practice. This takes training.
所以，当然这也是需要训练。
We are all conditioned souls. We're born in this world as conditioned souls.
因为我们就出生在这个受条件限制的地方世界里。
We have to try to get free of this condition.
我们应该试图着超越这种条件限制。
Conditioned souls have four defects.
受条件限制的灵魂有四种错误。
They make mistakes.
它容易犯错误，四种不完美。
Senses are not perfect.
他的感官不完美。
Subject to illusion.
容易被迷惑。
And we often cheat or we can be cheated.
而且容易欺骗和被欺骗。
I was giving a class in Vietnam in a yoga studio.
我在这个越南的一个瑜伽馆给了一堂课，讲了一堂课。
And there were, Vietnamese ladies were there.
通常这里有一些越南的这个女士也在那。
So I was telling them how in conditioned souls we have that problem that we often get cheated.
我就讲述了这个受条件限制的灵魂是如何容易被欺骗的。
And they all went, yes.
他所有人都在点头说是的。
They all had that experience.
所以从这里可以看到，所有人都肯定是受过骗、上过当。物质世界就是这样。特别是与这些物质世界打交道的时候，我们经常就容易被骗。而且是与那些比较色欲的男人。色欲的男人和这一个智慧比较少的女人，他们通常容易就欺骗和被骗。
So we have to awaken spiritual knowledge.
所以呢，对于我们来说，我们要唤醒灵性的智慧。
Understand the real situation.
要了解自己的这个真正的处境。
The process to come to this platform is practice of Krishna consciousness.
而这个唤醒的程序呢，就是修习 Krishna 知觉，不断的聆听和唱诵，聆听经典。通过这些方式呢，我们就知道我们的情况和处境。有问题吗？你说大点声
音。夫妻是这种关系，朋友也是，就是说有一些对你好的，有一些对你没那么好的，我们也要平等对待，不应该就是对你好那个是好一点，行的就行。
你说夫妻之间？
他讲的是夫妻之间嘛？我的意思就是说，夫妻之间或者朋友之间也不应该有这种，也要这样去。
So this is for the wife and husband. So for us, for the friend, our friend, some friend, these are friends. So we should be equal to all the friends. Yes.
What? You mean men, male friends? Men friends?
他说是男的男性朋友还是女性朋友？
女性的。
Women friend should be equal to all the women friends.
Well, we want to be equal to everybody.
你不应该 平等的对待所有的人。
But we see them equally. We see them all as spirit souls.
但是我们应该用灵性的眼光看待他们，都是平等的，他们都是平等的灵魂。
But some friends you'll be more intimate with. There'll be some friends you're more close to.
有一些朋友你更亲近。
You can't expect to be equal with all the people.
你不可能平等的对待每一个朋友。你和一些朋友有一些很好的关系，但是我们维系每一个朋友的这种关系，有一些朋友和你有特别好的关系，有一些朋友可以给你建议，有一些朋友则不然。
Some people may be your friend, they may have some motive. Their idea of friendship may be motivated.
有一些朋友跟你有很好的关系，但是他有可能怀有别的动机。友谊就是这样的，你是我的朋友，你应该帮助我。
So we have to be cautious.
啊，我们应该小心。
But we see everyone equally. Spiritual vision doesn't mean you deal with everyone the same way, but we see them all as spirit soul.
我们看待每一个人都是灵性的本性，但是。不意味着我们跟每一个人处理关系的时候是平等的。
Just like we see the tiger, the tiger is also spirit soul.
我们看这个老虎，它也是灵性的灵魂。
But you don't make friends with it, you know.
但是你不会和老虎交朋友吗？
Because they have their own nature.
它有它的本性。
They like human flesh. They like to eat.
他喜欢吃人肉，这个老虎。
So we're very careful how we deal with this kind of thing.
所以我们应该非常小心和这些动物相处。
But they're spirit soul.
但是呢，他们又是灵性的灵魂。
We try to give them mercy.
我们应该给予他仁慈。
Give them prasada.
给他 prasada.
Chant the holy name.
给他唱诵哈仁克什。
But we're very cautious.
但是我们也很小心和他相处。
The same way dealing with people.
同样的，我们和人相处。
We have to be able to discriminate.
我们也应该做出恰当的区分。
It's easy to make enemies. It's not easy to make friends.
非常容易树敌，并不容易交朋友。
We want to make friends.
我们想交朋友。
But it takes some time.
但这要花时间。
There was a problem just like Dronacharya. When he was in the Gurukula, he was a friend with Maharaj Drupada.
就像多纳查尔亚，他在这个学校和多帕达是朋友。
And they were very close, and they persevered, but always remained friends, and always wanted to be friends.
他们当时非常亲近，走的关系非常好，说我们永远是朋友。
But after they left Gurukula,
但是当他们离开 Gurukula 之后
，Then Drupada went back and he became the king. He became Maharaj.
多帕达呢，回去就当国王了。
Dronacharya, he's a brahmana.
多纳查尔亚，他是一个婆罗门。
So Dronacharya, you know, they both went, they got married, both of them. And Drupada, he had his family.
他们俩都结婚了。多帕达有他的这个大家庭，多纳查尔亚也结婚。
And Dronacharya, he had one son.
多纳查尔亚有一个儿子。
But Drona, the brahmana, Brahmanas, they don't work for anybody. They don't, so he didn't have any money. They were very poor.
多纳查尔是一个婆罗门，他婆罗门呢，他不会为任何人而工作，所以呢，他很贫穷。
And so some one day the other people they made fun of Dronacharya's son.
有一些人就跟多纳查尔的儿子开玩笑，取笑他。
His son was called Ashwatthama.
他的儿子叫阿什瓦塔玛。
So Ashwatthama, he never tasted milk.
阿什瓦塔玛从来没有喝过牛奶。
So they gave the other people, the other boys, they tricked him. They got some powdered chalk.And they put it in water, and they thought, "This is milk. Drink it. Here, take this."
啊，有一些人就给他开玩笑，而且嘲笑他，加了一些这个面粉还是什么样的东西，丢在这个水里面，和成一团，说这就是牛奶，请喝吧。
They use the chalk. Chalk. You write with it white.
哦，是这个粉笔上的那个白色的粉笔。
对，
把这个粉笔捏成灰，丢在这个水里面给他喝。
And so Ashwatthama he drank that, he didn't know that this is.
阿什瓦塔玛当时非常也什么都不知道，就相信他们喝了下去。
So Drona was very sorry, he felt very bad that they made fun of my son like this. This is not good.
多纳查尔就感觉到非常愧疚，我从来没为我儿子做一些好的事情。
So he went to see Draupada. He thought Maharaj Draupada is my friend. I will go and see him.
所以多纳查尔就去找多帕达王，说多帕达既然是我的朋友，他应该会帮助我。
But when Dronacharya came to see Draupada, Draupada said, "How can I be your friend? Friendship is only possible between equals."
多帕这个多纳查尔去找多帕达的时候，多帕达说：“你怎么可能是我的朋友？”朋友意味着是平等的。
So Draupada, he was a king and he was rich, and he didn't want to be friends anymore with Drona.
多帕达呢是一个国王，又很有钱，他那个时候已经不想跟多纳查尔成为朋友了。
Because he thought Drona is just a poor Brahmana with no money.
他认为多纳查尔只是一个贫穷的婆罗门，又没有钱。
I don't want this.
我不想跟他再成为朋友了。
You know, just like in materialistic society, like in Hong Kong.
在这个物质社会、物质世界，特别是在比如说香港这样的地方。
Friendship is you have to look how many digits do you have in your bank account, how many numbers.
啊，你的朋友建立在你在这个银行里面存了多少钱。
And you make friends with people who have the same number of digits.
你和那些跟你有同样家产的人成为朋友。
But if you are poor, you know, the rich people they don't want to.
这个富有的人他不会和穷人交朋友。
The materialistic society.
这就是物质世界的本性。
Actually, Drona was rich.
事实上，多纳查尔也很富有。
His wealth was in knowledge.
他的富有在于他的知识。
And in his austerity.
而且他的苦行也让他变得富有。
So after Draupada rejected Drona, then Dronacharya went to the Pandavas. He went to the palace of Hastinapur.
当这个多帕达拒绝了多纳查尔的时候，多纳查尔就去了潘达瓦兄弟所在的王宫。
And he became the guru for all the Kuru dynasty. He taught the sons of Dhritarashtra and he taught the sons of Pandu.
他成了这个潘度王以及整个王宫里面所有这些王子们的老师。
He made them his students and he taught them how to fight.
他让他们成为他们的学生，然后呢教他们如何作战。
And then he sent them, now go and fight Draupada, go run, attack him.
然后他就给这些王子们下命令，现在你和多帕达去打仗。
And they brought Draupada the prisoner, they tied him up and they put him in the teeth of Drona.
他的这些学生们就帮多纳查尔把这个多帕达给绑了回来。
But Dronacharya said, "It's okay, sir. I'm not going to take all your kingdom. I will just take half."
当他的学生为他赢得了这场胜利之后，这个多纳查尔就说：“我不要你的整个王国，我只要一半就好了。”
And so then he sent Dronacharya.
然后他就把多巴的给放走了。
So Drupada was very angry.
多巴的非常的生气。
So he did a sacrifice.
他做了一个祭祀。
And he got a son and a daughter from the sacrifice.
啊，他得到了一个儿子和一个女儿从这个祭祀。
The son was born to kill Drona.
这个儿子一出生，他的使命就是为了杀多纳。
Drishtadyumna.
对，是他舅母呢。
And the girl was Drupada.
这个女儿就是多帕提。
And she was the cause of the battle of Kurukshetra.
而她产生的，她是这个枯乳之野的原因。
Because of Drupadi, millions of people are dead.
因为多帕提，几百万的人口都死了。
It's the power of one woman.
这就是一个女人的力量。所有的男人都为此参战。
Of course, she was not an ordinary woman.
因为她不是一个普通的女人。
She was born from the sacrifice.
她是从祭祀之火中产生的。
She was actually she came from the higher planet.
她是来自于高等的星宿。
Her body had a very special aroma.
他的这个身体散发着一种特别的芳香。
Whenever people would even get a little smell of their bodily, they would become captivated, they would become drawn to it.
当一个男的哪怕为一丁点他身上发出的芳香时，都会被他为之着迷。
So this is why the battle of Kurukshetra.
这就是枯乳之野之战的原因。
So we see women are very wonderful devotees.
女性的
they
都是非常好的奉献者。
They do very wonderful service.
我们看到很多女性做了非常优秀的奉献服务。
But they can also create problems for men.
但是呢，由于男的，他也会制造一些麻烦。
So.When Prabhupada went to America,
当帕帕去美国的时候
he thought men will join. He came to get men to join to become.
他开始希望一些男的成为奉献者。
But then some women also came.
然后一些女的也同时来了。
So Prabhupada was surprised. He didn't think women would be interested.
他非常惊讶，这些女人怎么也能成为奉献者，也有兴趣做奉献服务。
But he decided that, you know, because it's a Western country, in the Western countries, the women, they do everything, they do all the same things the men do.
因为这是在西方世界，所以这些女的和男的都做着同样的工作。
So he said, give them a chance, let them also be devotees.
所以帕帕就说，既然如此，那就给他们一些机会，让他们做奉献服务。
Prabhupada's godbrothers, their temples are only for men, no women.
帕帕的一些神兄弟，他的庙宇只是为男的开放。他不渴望有一些女性参加。
But Prabhupada opened up.
但是帕帕打开了这个大门。
They give the women also the chance to be servants.
他同样给予女性机会来参加奉献服务。
But he also was aware that there would be problems.
他也意识到，他当然也意识到女性可能会带来一些麻烦。所以呢，他也非常小心，如何让这些女性能跟男性恰当的相处。
Because as described here in the Srimad Bhagavatam, even in the place of Swayambhuva Manu, there was this problem.
因为在圣典摩迦瓦堂，我们刚刚学习到，即便是在斯巴扬库瓦马努这个大家庭，他也会有这种麻烦。
So certainly in places like Bangkok.
同样的，在我们的这个曼谷也会有这样的麻烦。在中国，在印度同样如此。同样的问题也会发生。
So we have to be careful.
我们应该小心。
Men and women together is nice, but we have to also be cautious.
女性和男性在一起当然非常好，但是也应该小心的相处。
Okay, any other question?
还有别的问题吗？
Said, men are good, women are also good, but if they're together, then it's bad. Something like that?
Men are good, and women are good, men and women together,
it's bad.
No good.
You said something like that?
People say men and women together are better. No, when a couple got married, it's probably, but now you're married, so now you do twice the same. You do twice the same. A man on his own does so much, a woman on her own does so much, but men and women together can do much more. You can do much more. So when Prabhupada sent devotees to London, he didn't send sannyasis to open up London. He sent three household couples.
所以当圣帕帕德去派奉献者去伦敦的时候，他没有派sannyasi去，他派了三对居士。
And they were much more successful than the sannyasi.
啊，他们比这个sannyasi更为成功。居士呢，可以比三尼亚西去到更多地方。
三尼亚西 is just like here in Thailand, monks. You know, monks are supposed to be in the temple.
嗯，就像我们在泰国看到一些和尚，和尚意味着他大部分时间是住在庙里的。
There's a lot of monks, but you don't expect to see monks everywhere.
你不能期望一个和尚他到处走。
There's certain places and the monks don't want to go.
有一些地方这些和尚不愿意去。
Especially in a place like Bangkok.
特别是在曼谷。
Some places, some very places which are full of a lot of sinful.
有一些特别罪恶的活动。罪恶活动的地方场所。
And if they see a monk there, they'll be surprised. What are you doing here?
如果他们在那里看到一个和尚、一个僧人，他会觉得非常惊讶。你为什么会在这里
？Of course, we go there. We go there to preach and distribute books.
当然，我们去那里传教，去派发书籍。
But still, people are surprised. They don't like it.
但是仍然会有一些人。觉得非常惊讶，甚至不喜欢。
好。